Hi everyone, my name is Rinda. I am the area coordinator for Harborview Hall and Foundation Hall at Wagner College. Thank you so much for joining us on our live stream today. Joining me today is my fellow area coordinator, Matt Fowler. I will let him introduce himself.
Yeah, I'm Matt Fowler. I'm the area coordinator for Towers Hall and Guild Hall. Most of our sophomores and juniors live on campus and excited to meet you all today.
All right, so we're just gonna kind of go through some things for you to know for freshman move-in day. So obviously it's this Thursday, the 24th, coming up, very exciting. You all should have received an email from me by now with your designated move-in time. And we're just gonna kind of give you an idea of things to expect for move-in day, things you should be bringing, things that you should be mindful of during move-in day. It is a very chaotic day, so it is a little overwhelming, but we have scheduled teams that help you. They're called your color teams. You're assigned one when you show up, and they do all the move-in for you. Some things to be mindful of is the elevators during move-in day. You should have all received an email from me by now, which I mentioned already, but you should be receiving, you'll be coming to campus and you'll show up. You come up to the public safety booth. You all should show up with your parking pass pre-written. And from there, public safety, you take one and then they take one so that they have it on their records. They fill it out for you really quickly. You'll move on down the road and then you'll meet some of our welcome. Our mascot will be there, our welcome team will be there. And then from there, you'll get a color. You'll put that in the dashboard of your car. Please keep your stuff limited to one car. If you have two cars worth of items, or if you have, you know, family members in one car, items in another car, just bring that one car with you to the front of the line. That's where your move-in team will meet you. It'll delay the process if there's multiple cars. What else do they need to know?
At the move-in start of the spot, there is going to be a complimentary food truck. So if you want some coffee, some croissants, whatever, there's going to be things there for you because the line will be long. So if you show up on time, please expect to wait probably at least 20 to 30 minutes in the line. So feel free to talk to other people, grab some food, et cetera. But at least one person has to remain in the car in the driver's seat at all times.
Yeah, that was a good point. Some other things, please do not show up early. According to the email you were given, you are assigned the move-in time for each floor of Harborview. If you show up early, public safety will ask you to wait until your time is allotted. This is to kind of just help the process go a little bit more seamlessly. It's to really help us, you know, we work from the top down, so 14th floor gets the earliest move-in slot, and then the fourth or the third floor, I think, gets the latest move-in slot. So it's really just to help the process be a little bit more seamless. Be sure to label all of your items with your room number and your name. Because you put, some people just show up with just their name written on their stuff, and then we're like, we don't know where this goes. Some only put a room number and not a name. So be sure just to put both things on the items that you're bringing, just because it makes it easier for our moving crews. After you've been moving like 2 or 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 carts, you kind of just forget like what room things go to. So as long as you can, definitely like keep those things organized for us so that we don't forget where your stuff is and then it doesn't get lost and it's a lot easier to deal with.
Our goal is for you to not have to lift up a single bag throughout the day.
Mm-hmm.
So please help us. So before you come, be prepared, and the day of, you won't have to lift a single finger.
Yep. And this also goes, so for elevators, again, they are only for items. If there is someone who is physically unable in your family, or even if you yourself are not physically able, you know, to take the steps, we will allow you to take the elevators during those times, but for the most part, the only thing allowed in those elevators during those times are your move-in bins, your luggage, your refrigerators, if you bring anything like that. That's the only thing allowed during that time. Anything else I'm missing?
When you arrive, parents, you can stay, you can help set up the room,
yes,
et cetera. There's activities planned for after the actual move-in day is completed. That should already be sent to you in an email as well. But at a certain time, also in the email, all parents eventually have to say goodbye. And, you know, it's college, it's day one, so it lets your kids to stay. So
yep,
you can help set up all those things. But please remember, you have to leave by a certain time in the afternoon.
Yep. also for each of your floors. So the nice thing is that we have the Harborview RAs. There are one or two RAs assigned per floor. They will be there during your move-in time. So if at any point you have any questions or if you need anything, maybe something about a specific question about your room or maybe a policy or an event, the RA of your floor or the RAs of your floor will be there during that time. So if, like I said, if you have any questions, they are a perfect resource for you. They are currently in training, so everything that they need to know that you might possibly ask them, they are learning currently. And again, I will be there, so if you haven't figured it out, I'm the area coordinator for your building, as well as your graduate residence coordinator will be there. His name is Joseph Ravender. You might have received some emails from him already, but we'll be there move-in day. We'll definitely be some people that, some nice faces you get to see. Matt will be there. Our whole staff will be there, so it'll be nice to have these resources if you have any questions. That night, your RAs will have a floor program. It's not really a floor program. It's technically your first meeting of and you're just gonna go over just like policies to highlight in terms of things like quiet hours, the policies in terms of alcohol. Harborview is a dry building. Just some reminders for things you need to know, how to submit a work order. If at any point something breaks in your room, they'll teach you how to fill those out and to take care of those things. So definitely be sure to be at that floor meeting. It's a part of your orientation schedule, so you have to be there anyway, but this is me double emphasizing that you should be there to learn everything that your RA has to teach you. Can I think of anything else?
Oh yeah, lastly, when you come down and all the luggage is taken from your car and you go up and check in with Rinda and Joseph, all the stuff will be removed from your car. We ask that the car is immediately moved to the Spiro, Athletic Fields parking lot across Howard Avenue. So they will be directed by public safety. People will show you how to get there and then how to walk back to Harborview. We have limited spacing outside of the building, so we want to make it as efficient as possible. So at least one person always has to stay with the car when everything's being unloaded so you can drive away.
Right. I think the other nice thing for us to about move-in day is that it really is such an exciting time for all of you. You'll come down the hill, like after you get your color team, there's going to be music playing, it's going to be blasting. It's just a fun time. Everybody has so much energy. The move-in volunteers are so excited to help all of you and your family. It is really such an exciting time and it's so much fun and that's exactly what we want. So be sure to come. It might be a little scary, but be sure to at least stay open-minded and definitely stay positive, because that's the whole vibe of the day. It is your first day of college, so it can be a little scary, but it's going to be fun. We definitely make it fun.
Yeah. And we're here to support you if you have any questions or concerns or whatever. So you at least know two faces already before you arrive.
Yeah. I think a lot of the questions, at least I've been receiving the email that I kind of this is something that we can address for this live stream. I've had a lot of students ask me about lofting kits. If you are, so in each room, every double, it's a standard size, dorm room. There are two of everything in each room. If you want to maximize your space in your room, you can reserve a lofting kit. That'll be available for you the day of move-in. It'll be located in our lobby of Harborview. So what I will tell you to do right now is email harborview@wagner.edu, and there's a reservation system for lofting kits. This is just to help us make sure that our inventory is completely stocked for all those that we know that want it, and then some just for those who last minute need it. If you're going to bring any outside furniture with you, please be sure that it abides with the Wagner policy in terms of it needs to be that California, it's like a fire retardant, it's a specific number. If you go to our Wagner Res Ed website, the specific policy number is there for you to kind of refer to in terms of outside furniture. That way you don't get in trouble, we don't have to tell you, this isn't allowed in the hall, please bring it back. Things like, it just makes it so much easier, especially that Res Ed website helps so much in terms of what you need to bring and what you can't bring.
Hmm. Yeah, there's other things like the lamp policy.
Okay.
Check that out. Make sure you understand the lamp you're bringing abides by our fire safety codes, etc. There's a couple of things like your size of your fridge, your microwave, etc. So just take a look at that one more time before you arrive on campus. We don't want to tell you to send things back home.
And we will. Unfortunately, we definitely have those instances. We will definitely tell you, sorry, you have to put it back in your car. For the lamp one, that's another thing I've gotten a lot of questions about. I've had a lot of you email me saying, I had a student already, I don't know who they were, but they were awesome because they sent me actual pictures and they were like, which of these lamps can I buy? Basically, the bulb cannot be exposed. So if it's open facing and with the bulb exposed, we do not allow those, especially I know Target sells a ton of those large floor lamps. Those are not acceptable. As long as the lampshade, that was hard. Lampshade is facing down and the bulb is not exposed, you won't have an issue. We allow those. The only time we're kind of more lenient about those things is when it's like an actual desk lamp, because you can't really get those that aren't like the ones that bend and stuff like that. So those we aren't worried about. Normally the large floor lamps are the ones that we're a little more particular about. Yeah. Other things to be mindful of. No candles, no hot plates. If you do want to cook anything at any point, I mean, you're all paying for a meal plan. That's automatic from when you get here. But if there any time you want to like cook a meal or something like that, we do have a kitchen on campus available in Guild Hall, which is actually Matt's hall. How do they reserve the key if they need it?
Yeah, so what you would do is you would reserve by emailing the graduate residential coordinator of Guild. His name's James Walker. And you'll get more information on this later, but you can email him and say, hey, James, I'd like to reserve the kitchen. It has to be within at least a 24-hour window, I mean, maximum. So if today's Monday, I reserve it from 24 hours in advance. So if I want it Tuesday night, I'd have to reserve it before Monday night, et cetera. He'll approve it or deny it based on if it's full or occupied, et cetera.
Right.
And then you receive the key that day, and then it's all yours for the evening. We just ask that you clean up after yourself, make sure you leave it in the condition that is the same or better than you arrived in.
Yep.
And that's it.
I would also bring your own supplies, especially if you have like any allergies or something like that. We can't always promise that it's not going to be like cross-contaminated or something like that. So bring your own supplies if you can, and also clean up, obviously, after yourself. Other things to be mindful of, I sent it out in the email, but get to know, like, so you are all part of a living learning community called FIRE, which is the first year residential experience. Joseph, who I've already kind of mentioned in this live stream, is the graduate coordinator who oversees this program. These programs are for you. They are to help you get better acclimated to a college environment, you know. So we already have some programs planned for, you know, getting to know your roommate better, or getting to know just people in your residence hall. Definitely come to these events. They are fun. We give away prizes. We always have food. We always have music. But yeah, they are for you. And then to kind of piggyback off of that, your RAs will do floor programs for you. And a lot of them will ask you, like, what kind of floor programs do you like or would you want to see? There's always some type of an educational component to these floor programs, but they're mostly just for you to help to maintain that community or build that community in your hall. A really big popular program a lot of our RAs do is kind of like a speed dating, so that you get to know everybody on your floor, but it's more just like friend networking, I think is what they call it. That's always a popular program. Trying to think of other popular programs. There's always, we have like our noted yearly one. So there's like Towers of Terror, which is in October. We always have an opening program in Harborview or Foundation or even in Guild. Trying to think, like, then there's like Midnight Breakfast, but that's not till the end of the semester.
Mm-hmm.
There's like other programs. Oh, Homecoming, but that's like not us.
Lip Sync Battle.
Oh, yeah.
Nights, the open mic nights,
mm-hmm.
et cetera. Yeah.
There's lots of programs, but ultimately they're all for you. So be sure to come to them, take full advantage of them. Don't be afraid to get involved. There is an activities fair, which you'll learn more about from your RAs for when you have that first floor meeting. It's, can't remember, I think it's like during the first week of classes. I can't remember the specific date, but Co-Curricular Programs is the one that hosts that event. So basically every organization on campus will have a table there, and that's like their way of recruiting or getting information about their club or organization. Be sure to definitely get involved. It's just going to make your experience at school so much better. And it's honestly what, I mean, it's the reason why Matt and I are both in this profession, is because we got involved. Whether you want to become an RA, a part of Greek life, or whether you want to join like a charity organization or a volunteer organization, there's basically so many things that you can do on this campus. And it's a small campus, but it could feel really big. And the best thing you could do is get involved and really find your own community or find your own niche. Or I think that's just like always, that's like the first thing I always tell first years when they get to campus. So yeah, definitely get involved.
To piggyback on that, it's totally cool and it's totally fine to be uncomfortable. And we strive to push you to be comfortable with being uncomfortable.
Yeah.
That applies to your entire 4 years of college. You should always be pushing yourself. And these first 2, 3, 4 weeks of college are really designed to really help you if you want the help, and if you need the help, grab it, take for it, ask for it. We're there. There's a bunch of different faces and people who are providing different opportunities for you to learn and grow and have a great time.
Mm-hmm.
So there's always something to do every night in the first essentially month of campus.
Sure.
You know, grab those opportunities. Yeah.
Yep.
Have a great time.
That was good. Yeah. I'm trying to think other things to note. Definitely write your stuff, like on your items for when you move in. Trying to think anything else.
No, I think it's it for now. I think we can open this up for questions. So if anyone wants to ask us any questions or whatnot, we can start answering any questions and leave any answers or concerns.
Yeah. That sounds good.
So I'll wait for the first one to come in and see if I have any on my phone yet.
Oh, you have to look at my phone.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool.
Okay. I have one here. So Tom asked, Tom G asked, what if I plan to bring two cars?
Okay, so if you plan to bring two cars, that's a really good question. What's likely going to happen, so kind of what we talked about before, those color teams, we need, basically it's one team per like student, so the idea is one team per car. What'll likely happen is you will be asked to re-get in line because that second car is ultimately delaying the process. So that's why we're really encouraging everyone to squeeze as many items into one car as possible. If you need, again, if you need to bring two cars for the sake of like fitting family members in, I would squeeze all my family members in that other car, and then the student, if you are the student and your person driving the car in that other car that carries the majority of your stuff. Because we don't really wanna have to tell you to get to the back of the line or delay the process, but you will see. That's why you have those scheduled move-in times to really not hold up any process. It really is like, you'll be, I promise, there's few things I'm like easily amazed at, but I think for us, like the move-in day process to me always blows my mind because we do it, like we have it down to a science. Like public safety knows what to do and like our students know what to do, we know what to do, and it's just like, it's so simple and easy. The thing that throws the monkey wrench in those plans though is that second car or that third car. We had a student last year who bought three cars, and that held up the line quite a bit because we needed three teams to then go to that one student's car to take all those items away, and that's just not really fair. So be mindful, be courteous, but that's a really good question.
Yeah, and Tom, if worst comes to worst and, you know, grandma, mom, dad, cousin Larry, girlfriend, boyfriend, etc., all want to come and see you off on your first day of college, bring the second car of friends and family and the first car of stuff, and then the car of friends and family can park at the sports center lot, and then they can come down and walk and join you in Harborview. We encourage all of your friends and family to come if they want to enjoy this with you, but only one car full of belongings for your room can come down.
Yeah, it really is true. Another question we're getting is size of refrigerators. So again, if you go to our Res Ed website, there is a certain amount of watts that you permit. I think it's no more than like 40. I think it's like no more than 40 is what it's allowed. But if you go on the website, it'll definitely be there. You will see. So what happens is if you bring anything bigger, the electricity or the generators in our buildings, it'll overwork them. So that's why there's a certain restriction on how many watts of the refrigerator you can bring. Also, please talk to your roommates about things that you are bringing to the room. So if your roommate's bringing a refrigerator, you might want to share. If it's not feasible, you know, you want your own separate ones, that's okay too, but make sure you're maintaining those by our policies and those guidelines, because we don't want to have to, again, tell you to put that refrigerator back in, back into the car and take it back home. I also know that if you wanted to rent something, we do have collegiate storage and rental. They are on campus today, but if last minute you want to do a rental, I'm sure they'll work with you. They're a great resource. They deliver the items for you and they'll pick them up at the end of the year and take them back for you once you're done renting them. So they're an awesome resource. And also if you wanted to, this is another question that I've gotten a ton of emails about. If you want to ship anything, the day of, if you don't want to take all your items in the car and you want to send things like via mail, especially if you're coming from really far away, like California or something like that, or even another country. We have our shipping and receiving office, so it's also our mail room. It's all in the same building. They will be there the day of move-in. So if you want to pick up your packages, you absolutely can. They're open until about 4 o'clock. They will also be open the Friday. They're not open on weekends. So if you want to go and get your stuff after, I strongly encourage you to go the day, either Thursday or Friday, to go pick up your items, because it's not going to be available come the weekend. And again, like, that's a smart idea, but make sure that, again, you're labeling all the things that you are shipping. We have had some students before who have just mailed it and then didn't put like a room number or like even like a full name. So we had no idea where the package belonged to and it got lost in the mailroom. So just put like Harborview and your room number, your name, and it'll be in the mailroom for you when you arrive. Yep.
All right, next question. Okay, Curtis W. says, okay, what if I'm in the first group and orientation's later in the afternoon? What do I do when I finish setting my room up? So that's a good question. So what do you do if your move-in time's at 7 a.m. and orientation starts in the afternoon?
Yeah.
That's honestly up to you. Take the time to really set up your room, do your RCRs properly, which is a form that we do when we arrive. Rinda can talk about that in a second.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure you do that properly. Get to know your RA. Get to know the people on your floor. Spend that time to really get to know the campus. Walk around with your friends and family. Maybe venture off campus a little bit to see what just the surrounding couple of blocks offers you. You know, sit down, enjoy the Oval, etc. You know, you have... this is your first day at campus, make it as memorable as you can be, and then we have planned activities for you starting in the afternoon.
Yeah, orientation has a ton of stuff for you planned, but that's actually a really good point. The best piece of advice I ever got, was actually from my cousin my first day of college, was he just said, your first day in your hall, like, keep your door open and, like, go to every open door you see and introduce yourself. Like, just try to get to know as many names and faces as possible. So that's actually a really good point Matt just made. Like, this is your community for the next year. And again, we try to make it as fun as possible, but you kind of have to do some of the work too. So definitely get to know as many people as possible. Matt talked about room condition reports. So when you check in, so after your car, you've gotten to your car, you know, we pull you out of the car and say, yay, welcome to Wagner, like go check in. You'll get a key agreement form, which you have to sign. And basically the key agreement form states that you are aware that this key is your responsibility. In the event you lose it, you will immediately report it to us. That way we can change the locks and get those keys changed and make sure that, you know, there's no like breach of security or that, God forbid, someone would be able to get into your room. So we change that core right away. Then from the next thing in line is the room condition report. The room condition report is your responsibility. This is what we assess damage billing from at the end of the year. So you're going to go into your room, the RA will explain a little bit more, but you'll go into your room, you'll fill out all the information at the top of the RCR, you'll take account of what's in the room. So, you know, there's two bed frames, two mattresses, two chairs, two desks, things like that, like two closets, obviously, but that's not in the room. That's not given to you, that's just in the room. It's, they're already there. You will then make a note of everything you see. So if there's potentially, you know, a spackle on the wall or like a paint chip or something, just like anything you could appear of. If there's potentially a scratch on the desk, make a note of it on your room condition report, because at the end of the year, when we go through the rooms and assess the condition of all of them, we get an idea of, okay, this is what they moved into the room with, and then that'll help us make our work orders from those things. So we'll tell maintenance, you know, this needs to be painted, this needs to be fixed, this needs to be replaced, and then you don't get billed for that. So it's really to make sure that you're advocating for yourself the second you walk into that room. We do our best to kind of get an idea of the conditions of the room before you move in. But, you know, like, for example, since I'm the area coordinator of that building and I have the grad, I do have the RAs, but there's a lot of rooms in Harborview and there's only so much I could be as detail oriented about. So that's why I really put the emphasis on all of you to kind of make sure that you're being thorough with those room condition reports. And if you lose it, let us know right away. But they are due at a certain time. I think they're due right before Labor Day weekend, that Friday. So September 1st?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, they're due that September 1st. So be sure to give them in. You can give them to your RA, you can give them to me, you can give them to the grad. Just make sure they're in by that date. If you do not get it in by then, unfortunately, you will forfeit your right to damage billing, which, again, is all on our ResEd website if you don't know what that means. I mean, we can get into a whole damage billing, but I think that'll bore you during this live stream, so I wouldn't say that. But it's on our website. So definitely those room condition reports will really help you, as long as you definitely make sure that you do your due diligence with them. That was a really good question.
All right. Next up from John H. Okay, so will we be able to have someone on board to help us assemble all of our computer and IT equipment the day of move-in day? It's another good question, John H. So our residence halls, every room has Ethernet cables, so the Ethernet cables can be used for your laptop, your personal computer, if you have like a smart TV, etc. The Ethernet cables should, when you plug them in, immediately give your computer or your device automatic access to the internet. We also have Wi-Fi in all of the rooms.
Mm-hmm.
You do need to log in through our Wi-Fi. So we have two separate Wi-Fis, Wagner Visitor and then Wagner Roam. Wagner Roam is something that you can use your username and your password that when you arrive, you'll be able to access it all, only for actual college users
right.
at Wagner. So we can eventually log in and use that for other devices. Please look and visit the IT webpage or see any communications from them. Certain devices aren't supported on our Wi-Fi. For example, some gaming systems like Xbox,
yeah.
PlayStations, etc. I think maybe Rokus aren't provided as well.
I don't think so. I thought Roku maybe was supported.
Maybe
Apple TV isn't the one that's supported.
One of those is, one of those isn't maybe. So just please check those out and really understand like what you're bringing, because you don't want to bring either an Apple TV or a Roku and
right.
realize that you're not going to be able to use it.
Yep.
So check that out, the IT page tonight, tomorrow before you arrive.
Yeah, I was just going to say, also the day of move-in, so when we have our res ed move-in station, there's also an IT person. So if you do bring any of these type of things and need to get them hooked up, there will be an IT assistant right in the lobby. Well, the Gatehouse Lounge is where we'll be checking in. There'll be someone there. There'll also be someone from maintenance, shipping and receiving. There'll be people from orientation there. So even if you like walk into your room and in the event, like last minute, like let's say one of your shades broke, you come right back down to the lobby. We'll teach you how to do the work order, but maintenance will be right there and accessible. So they'll be able to go right up to your room and make sure that it's assessed or taken care of. So that'll be really nice. But the other thing is if your parents want to access the Wi-Fi because you need an at wagner.edu to access it, there is a Wagner guest, which is temporary, so that's pretty nice. If they want to be able to get onto the internet, they absolutely can. But yeah, we're winding down on the live stream here, so we'll take
the last question or two questions.
We can go to the last question.
Cool. This is a good one. All right, so we'll go from Angie C. Okay, so Angie C asks, Rinda, you talked a lot about your RAs and getting to know them day one. How do we know who's our RA when we arrive on the floor? Okay.
All right, yeah. So that's a really question. If you go back to the email I sent you, again, if you did not get this email, although I'm pretty sure all of you did, please email me. But I referenced who your RA is in that specific email. But if you can't find her or something like that, they will be on the floor the day of. Also, when you walk into our lobby of Harborview, there will be like a giant like get to know the staff board, and you will be able to see who the RA of each floor is based on their pictures, and there might be like a fun fact about them. Even throughout the year, though, like because our res ed staff, I feel like they are so, they're not just RAs. A lot of them are also really involved in other things. You will get to know them you'll know they're an RA immediately throughout the year. Like, they don't even have to be the RA of the floor, and you will know that they're an RA just because it is something that they're just constantly involved, and I think it's such a big part of their identity that, like, I feel like they introduce themselves as an RA regardless of if they're on duty or anything. So you will get to know them throughout the year, even the ones that are on your floor, but I often find that the ones on the floor obviously are the ones you become closest with, and that they're the ones that encourage you to get involved. We've had a ton of residents that became so close with their RAs that they then applied to become RAs. Also something I encourage you all to do if you want like a good leadership position, apply to become an RA, but that's not until the spring semester, so you have some time to learn about that.
What will they be wearing the day of move-in day?
That's a good question. Is that the polo?
They'll
be wearing a polo like this, and it'll say Res Ed, it'll say Wagner Res Ed right here. So anyone wearing basically a green Wagner polo is a resource for you. So Matt wore it just for this live stream for all of you to help give you a visual. Like I'll be in the polo. They might be gray polos. Are they green? Are they green or are they gray?
For our student staff, they're green like this. They have little white sleeves. And then our professional staff members, so people like Rinda and I and some of our others, will be wearing different colors, so either gray or black or something like that.
Yeah. So they'll be pretty easy for you to find unless you all
have big name tags too. So
yeah. You'll know who we are immediately. All right, well, we're going to wrap up this live stream. I hope you all are enjoying the eclipse outside. I'm going to hop on a live stream and watch that myself. But thank you all so much for joining us, for your amazing questions. We cannot wait to see you on Thursday. And if you have any other questions, be sure to email either resed@wagner.edu or harborview@wagner.edu or just my email, Matt's email. Whatever questions you may have, that's what we're here for. But thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you Thursday.
Bye.